afternoon, everyone. I'm Jean Morrison. I'm the President and CEO at St. Paul's Hospital. Before we begin, I'd like to first acknowledge that we're on Treaty 6 territory and the homeland of the Métis. And in addition, I'd like to recognize the Honourable Jim Reiter, Minister of Health, who's with us today. Thank you, Minister. As well, we have Mike Stensrud, the Chair of the Regional Health Authority Board, who's joined us as well, and they'll be speaking later on. So thank you both for coming, and thanks to everyone who's here to join with us today. It's great to see a good crowd. It was just 2.5 months ago that Saskatoon Health Region implemented its first accountable care unit. This is a new and innovative way of providing quality care directly to our patients. And I have to say I'm particularly proud because I remember being in a meeting about 18 months ago where Dr. Gowda said, you know, we need to do something different. We need to have a pilot and have doctors assigned to a specific unit so we can work in a different way. Well, we got there and we got more because we've adopted a developed model that's been tried and tested elsewhere. So far, the unit has received an incredible response. It's been very encouraging for us as it's translating into positive outcomes that we know will change the way we provide care to patients across the whole province. As some of you may know, Regina Qu'Appelle Health Region has already implemented and started an accountable care unit at the Pasqua General Hospital. Their work confirmed what we were already seeing in the areas where we were conducting multidisciplinary rounds in our region, that improved provider team communication has the ability to reduce patients' length of stay, which has a direct impact on the flow and bed availability. We launched our own accountable care unit in April, and as you can imagine, it's been a truly rewarding experience and a real ride since then. People have been working hard. I want to take this moment to acknowledge the manager and staff of Seventh Medicine. I saw Melissa here somewhere, there she is, and staff back there. Thank you very much for everything you've done to make this first unit a great success for us. To give you an idea of what happens on the accountable care unit, we're going to show you a short video that was just shot last week. This video showcases one of the key components of the accountable care unit, and that's the standardized interdisciplinary bedside rounds. The video doesn't have audio at the request of the patients we filmed, so I will provide some description of what's happening as it goes along. Our video begins with the interdisciplinary team gathering at the nursing station. They're getting ready for bedside rounds with the patients on seventh floor. This interdisciplinary team is made up of a physician, bedside nurse, and any other healthcare specialists that are required by the patient. This might include a physiotherapist, an occupational therapist, a dietitian, a pharmacist, a social worker, and/or a representative of the client-patient access services. An accountable care unit is made up of four key components. They are having all members of the care team, including the physician, physically located together on the same unit, performance reporting on the unit level for improved responses to care, a nurse and physician who act as co-leads of the unit, and what you are seeing in this video, which is called standardized interdisciplinary bedside rounds. These bedside rounds make the accountable care unit special. As you can see, this method puts the physician, the nurse, and all the other members of the team at the patient's bedside at the same time every day. This gives the patient and the family a sense of comfort, knowing exactly when they can have their next opportunity to speak to members of the care team. It also allows the team an opportunity to collaborate with the patient and their family to have an open conversation about the patient's care. You'll see in the video that each healthcare provider takes turns providing timely and relevant information to the patient. One of the most important things to note in the video is that the patient is always included in the discussion. They're encouraged to ask questions if they don't understand something or to correct any information as they go. The team usually spends 3 to 5 minutes with the patient, and when they've covered everything, they move to the next patient. So far, this system has had very positive impact on patient care. On average, our patients in this unit are heading home 2.5 days earlier, which means they're happier because they get to go home and be in their own surroundings more quickly and back to their regular life. This unit has also meant a significant reduction in the average number of patient transfers to other units. We went from transferring 45 patients a month before the accountable care unit was introduced to just 8 transfers in May. That's just a great improvement. This is important because the transfers are disruptive to the patient. They also slow down patient flow within the system by closing access to 2 beds at the same time during the transfer. But overall, the number one reason we're doing this is because the patient experience is better. In fact, one of the patients recently had this to say about the accountable care unit. The changes on 7th Medicine made this latest hospital stay very different from my previous ones. I feel listened to. I feel like my needs are being met quickly, and I like the daily rounds where I see my doctor and my nurse. So what a great testimony to the work that's being done on 7th Medicine, and we look forward to a great deal more. So I'd now like to invite Minister Reiter to speak on behalf of the Government of Saskatchewan.
Thank you very much. Honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege to be here this afternoon on behalf of the Government of Saskatchewan and Premier Brad Wall. I have some prepared statement I'd like to deliver to you in just a minute, but I just want to make some observations. First of all, as I watched the video, I had the opportunity a number of weeks ago to be part of a similar type announcement in Regina, and I had an opportunity that day to actually go on that tour with the medical professionals and seeing a patient. And I have to tell you, you know, over the years, I think everybody in this room can attest to this. Often in our medical system, I think patients sometimes feel that they're sort of left out of the knowledge of what's going on. They're not quite sure what's happening with their treatment or when they're going to see the doctor next or the nurse next, whatever that may be. It was incredible what I saw on that tour that day, and that just brought back the memory of it. And I think the statistics speak for themselves. So I know in government we're very excited about this. I want to thank all the healthcare professionals that have been working diligently on this, and we're very excited where this is going. And we just see this getting bigger and bigger and expanding more and more in the future. So with that, I'd just like to do a quick prepared statement and we'll move along. Our population has grown and has put more pressure on our major hospitals. We've invested $12 million to ease the overcapacity pressures on our hospitals and reduce emergency department times in Regina and Saskatoon. In 2016, an accountable care unit was introduced as a pilot in one unit of the Pasqua Hospital in Regina. At the end of that pilot, Regina Qu'Appelle Health Region reported there was less time waiting for an inpatient bed, shorter hospital stays, better patient outcomes, and an increased patient family and staff satisfaction. This innovative team-based model of inpatient care has already shown tremendous results there, and we're pleased now with it being adopted in Saskatoon. In fact, there is a plan in place to convert the remaining 2 medicine units at St. Paul's to accountable care units by 2018. The results of these units will have a positive ripple effect throughout the region, and we expect this model will help reduce the congestion that our major hospitals are too often experiencing. These accountable care units are an important element of a larger connected care strategy to ensure patients have seamless access to the services that they need. It has taken dedication and hard work for many people throughout the health system to help tackle this long-standing problem. I want to thank everyone involved for the strong support that they have shown for this initiative. We're incredibly proud of this initiative, and as I said, we're looking for great things into the future and continued expansion of this type of program. So again, thank you for allowing me to be part of this great announcement today. Thank you very much.
So thank you, Minister Reiter. We'll now hear from Mike Stensrud, our chair of the Saskatoon Regional Health Authority. You wish you were the chair of St. Paul's, no. to speak on behalf of the region.
Good afternoon, everyone. Mr. Minister, I wanted to thank you for your kind remarks and your consistent commitment to the patient needs. In our time together, nothing has struck me more than that commitment that you have personally and that you bring forward from government. I wanted to acknowledge here with me today our fellow board members, Malcolm Eaton and Bobby Lynn Stewart. I lost you in the light, but there you are. Thank you very much for coming. The Accountable Care Unit changes to the structure here at St. Paul's is a big deal. This is a very big deal for patients. I'm sure some are sitting there going, I wonder what this is all about. This doesn't sound like it's that out of the ordinary. And it isn't, because common sense things usually aren't out of the ordinary. There was a lot of discussions in Regina about changes that have to happen that our health authority has been championing and the government has been very receptive to. These types of changes are transformational in our care. And they're leading to less time in hospital, as we've talked about, the freeing up of beds, which is also important to the system and the sustainability of the system. But maybe one of the things that isn't in the notes that is really important is how much safer it is for patients to get out of the hospital as quickly as possible. It is just a reality of being in hospital. The immobilization of patients, the stopping of the daily routines. I don't know if you've noticed, because there's so many young people in the audience, but when I get up now, and at the ripe age of 56, my hands are kind of sore. And it takes a little time to get going. Wait till you're 88. See how quickly you get out of bed after you've been immobilized in a bed in hospital for 2 weeks. So anything that we can do to help patients move out as quickly as possible, that's what we do. I've heard from patients that have experienced the changes in Seventh Medicine. And there's just no question that our patients believe the care is better, the communication is better. So many things in this life are connected to communication. And I'm so very proud of government's commitment, the health region's commitment, our leadership's commitment, and especially the good people on Seventh Medicine who are leading this forward in Saskatoon. This is a big deal, and I thank you very much for your efforts.
Thank you, Mike. I'd like to take a moment to introduce our next speaker. Dr. Ann Paz-Jensen was the lead physician involved in setting up the Accountable Care Unit in St. Paul's. Because of how an Accountable Care Unit is structured, the role of the physician differs from what the traditional setup has been. I described some of that earlier, talking about how they're physically located on the unit, rather than rounding on patients throughout the hospital. They're part of the management team on the unit and are part of the team that performs daily rounds on the patients. And as most of you here know, change is tough. We have those practices and the way we do things well ingrained in each of us, and changing that and getting to a different place isn't always that easy. Dr. Paz-Jensen has been instrumental in making all of this possible in Saskatoon. She's patient, thoughtful, listens well, does a great job of bringing together the thoughts that come from clinicians and non-clinicians and sometimes mediating our way through that. And I'm just really pleased that she was willing to take that on and to help gently coach us to a different place than we've been. And it takes, all of us need that coaching. So thank you for that. Dr. Paz Jensen is going to speak to us about her experience and what's been happening on Seventh Medicine.
Thank you for that kind introduction. And I'm very honored to speak on behalf of the Seventh Medicine team. And thank you very much, Minister of Health, for coming today and showing such a clear sign of support for the work that's being done. When I first heard about the accountable care units about a year ago, I have to admit I was a little suspicious. It frankly sounded too good to be true. How could something so simple, so common sense, really transform care? How could putting a doctor on one floor and having all the patients be around them and having them participate in team-based rounds really be so different and transform the patient's experience? So when I heard about this and got the opportunity to go down to Regina and visit Pasqua myself, I jumped at the opportunity and I came back thoroughly excited and thrilled to be part of the team to work to bring it to Saskatoon. But it was only really when I started working on the unit that I felt how different it was. My days used to be filled with running from floor to floor, getting paged by worried nurses to come urgently to see a patient, flipping through patients' charts, trying to find that important piece of nursing information that would be the key to understanding what was going on in that patient's care. And I'd been a staff doctor now for 20 years and had worked in two different provinces, and frankly, I was getting a little bit tired, and I wasn't sure I could keep up this pace. But now, my days are very different when I'm working on the accountable care team. Now, all my patients are in one area. Now, I start every day by meeting with my charge nurse and coming up with a plan together about what are the key issues that have to be addressed and when. And now, I'm part of a team. And with that team, I go and see the patients and listen to the patients and hear from them what are their key priorities that need to be addressed that day. And by putting the patients front and center for their care plans and hearing from them what's important, together as a team, we can move to improve their health and get them home. And I love my job again. And I'm thrilled and excited to hear that we'll have more accountable care units coming to the province and coming to Saskatoon. And there certainly are many, many people that have made this happen, and I'd like to take a minute to thank them for that. Dr. Sam Haddad in the Department of Medicine and George Pilipchuk in the Health Region have been very encouraging and very helpful in breaking down the barriers and encouraging us to start this pilot. Melissa Babcock and Brian Witt and Jackie Mann at the Health Region have been instrumental and have spent countless hours in meetings making this work. The team up on 7, and there's too many health professionals to mention, but the general internists as well, they kind of all took on this challenge and have made it work. Graham Fast at Health Quality Council has been a great resource and frankly set up some key meetings between Saskatoon Health Region and Regina Health Region. And of course, I would like to thank the docs in Regina Health Region and their team leaders as well for opening the doors and sharing their work. And of course, my final thanks goes to the Minister of Health for having a clear vision for how to improve health care in the province of Saskatchewan. I'm very grateful.
Thank you, Dr. Paz Jensen. So now I'd like to call on Dr. George Pilipchuk. Dr. Pilipchuk is our Chief Medical Officer and our Vice President of Practitioner Staff Affairs. Have to get that long handle all out there. He's worked closely with Dr. Paz Jensen, Dr. Sam Haddad, our Department Head for Medicine, to ensure the success of the implementation of the Accountable Care Unit and to get us going. So, George.
Thank you, Jean. Mr. Minister, honorable guests, and ladies and gentlemen. So I've been asked to say a few words on behalf of the medical staff. I'm going to start with a story. And this is a story, a doctor's story, not a patient story. Usually we start with patient stories. This is a doctor's story. About 2 years ago, we were up on the sixth floor of medicine, again, pulling our hair out because we had flow issues, long stay issues. We had a difficult time. We were trying to meet with the general internist to get our patients well looked after and moved. One of the general internists said to me, oh, by the way, I've been doing a study on myself. I said, really? He says, yes, I've been wearing a pedometer, and I want to tell you that when I make rounds every day in this hospital, it's about 5 kilometers. So he was walking 5 kilometers per day. So, you know, I think simple solution, we just put everybody on the same ward and you've got it made. Well, in medicine, everything's not that simple. So I got a second story. So on the way here, I stopped and talked to the physician who does a lot of our night work. And I said to him, how are things going here? He says, you know what, amazing. I said, what do you mean by amazing? He said, you know, I work most of the nights, and all of a sudden, my work is a lot better. Like Dr. Paz Jensen said, my work is a lot better. I look after all the medical floors, but I used to spend a lot of my time putting out fires and not getting time to go to emergency, the new patients to be admitted. I would spend a lot of time putting out fires. But all of a sudden now, the fires are all out when I come to work at 5 o'clock and I'm doing on emerge. So I've been around here a long time, and many people say much too long. But you know what? This is more than just a unit. This is a culture change. And people say, how do you change culture? Well, let me tell you, this has changed culture. If you look at the other medical floors, we tout the good results that we're seeing on this seventh floor, which is great. But if you look at the other medical floors, what have we found? Decreased lengths of stay, more satisfaction, more competition. I think the other floors want to look like seventh floor. And I think people are starting to recognize that, wait, this is the way to do it. The way to do it is to have teams. And most physicians know that team-based care is the best care. And all physicians want this for their patients. They want the best care. So I think that we're all very excited. It's about time. I think we're seeing the culture change. And again, two things were needed to make this team. One is a financial kickstart, and we thank the provincial government for this, because without that, this wouldn't have started. And also our human resource, our nurses and our practitioners and our physicians. They came up to the plate and they hit a home run. Thank you very much.
So thank you, Dr. Plipchuk. So we've come a long way in a few weeks, and frankly, I can hardly wait to see the spread. As Dr. Plipchuk said, people are already grabbing what they can, changing the way they practice, but when they have that formalized structure with them and have the education, it's going to be great. And it's not just the change at St. Paul's or in Saskatoon Health Region, but seeing this spread across the province and impacting everyone is something that lots of us have been hoping for a long time. And in addition, the work that's going on in the community to enhance and develop our community supports is part of that larger strategy to improve emergency room waits is something that everyone cares about, wants, and will make a vast improvement to the care we provide. So like Dr. Paz Jensen, I thank everyone for coming today, but I also want to thank Seventh Floor and Melissa for your strong leadership in this, and Brian Witt for leading on behalf of our directors group within Seventh, and for Jackie Mann, who's not here this week, for the leadership she's provided sponsoring this event. So thanks for coming out. Have a great weekend, and hopefully the sun will shine.